First thing you'll notice, no laser until I get one. Without the laser, this will not detect on any PC, no matter what it is. This is what I got off of Solar, it's brand new obviously, but as you can see, no laser, no detector, no PCs, not even a laptop. It's a good mouse, I'm just waiting for the Rat 8 Plus now, so I know I've got every single one of them, as you can see. All the changeable parts to the damn thing. Just got hooked on buying Rat Mat mouses. As you can super it up with all different parts. Looks like a blaming Lamborghini. So, if you compare that, I've got other Rat mouses. If you compare that one, this one's just as fast as it anyway. And you got the Cyborg Rat 7, which is a mean one. Hard drive sector fixing. Now back to the mouses. Those are the other changeable parts, as you can see. Different side slots. Pretty nifty and pretty cool looking as well. Time being, I'll cut this video short. Put some of the back pieces away first. As you can see, the Subaru thing looks like the back of a goddamn Lamborghini or something. Kind of mad looking really. Then, obviously, you can lift that thing up and change it. Different colours you want. I'm not going to bother changing it now, obviously, but... simple. You can adjust that, obviously. Different side rest, as you can see what you can change over. So there's a nice looking mouse, it's not as fast as that one. Right, yeah actually it is. And this one, the Tournament TE edition, that's just as fast as that one anyway. That's for the Rat 8 Plus what we'll get tomorrow, that's 16,000 DPI, so that'd be powerful. That one I'm just waiting for a laser so I can slot underneath, then it'll detect on the machine. It's kind of a cool looking mouse right there. As you can see, they look a bit similar. Actually they look identical. That one, obviously, Mad Cat, that's for the opposite side, which I've not slapped on yet. I don't need to because they all look blaming similar. Just got a glide piece on the side of it. Obviously it's just not as tough or strong as that one. So I'd say that one is the strongest first. That one is second, and also got one third. It just depends how you handle the mouse. was coming under. So we'll soon find out how fast that Lamborghini looking thing is. I want to get the laser for it. I've ordered 8200 DPI. There's the other side glide piece. Well, it's quite a nice looking mouse, but when you're going to play games in that, just got to watch how you handle the damn thing, because of these magnetic sliders. So you can use it on your leg or on your bed or whatever, or on a table, but anything too rough, it will slide them off no matter what. Like I said, that thing will not detect without the laser slapped underneath it. I'll try and attempt to change this stuff roller bottle to a black one. As you can see, the thing lifts up in the air. Silver off. And I'll put a black rubber one on if I can get the damn thing out of the box. So, off. And slot. Playing black on instead. So the silver one felt like it was rolling a bit wrong. That's where you can adjust it. How sensitive you want that. It's going up and down, so it's just normal. And just slot that back down. There you can see. Crazy mouse, really. Top design. So when I get the laser, and you slot it on at the back of there, it'll say Mad Cats on the back of the laser. So it's highly customizable. But that one, that's my main gaming mouse at the moment because that's fast as hell. That one is, but I've got all the counterweights now, as you can see. And that's 5600 DPI. And this one is around about 8200 DPI. AMD ATA PCI with two R990Xs in it. 850 limited edition Black XP Core Edition 8 core AMD processor, Blu-ray burner. LED lights, 15,000 gigabyte drive space. Yeah, I'll show you the parts, but go with that. Mad locking mouse. Yeah, they give you stickers for it just like you get the keyboard. Then you get the small little screwdriver. As you can see, there's the picture diagram where the laser slots in. Without that laser, this will not detect on any PC. No matter what. No, because that's already got a laser already built in. And you can't take it out, that'll detect straight away. So anyone who tries to attempt to connect this to a PC, it will not detect. Only until that laser slapped underneath it with the little chips. Now I'm gonna change the side piece. So this is just a one-off small video clip. Once again, there is a small little screwdriver, hexagon shape, just like you see on the bigger one over there, but a bit thinner. And that's for the side slots. So, take this side slot out. Off. Obviously I'm not going to get it back in that box cage because the other one will be bigger. We'll soon see. I'll take that thing out. And we'll put the other one on. The only thing is hard to put these things together, so simple. So it's only got two slots. Holes. One for the screw and two little slots for the sides. So I'm going to screw the side piece on. So the mouse is going to look kind of mad looking once it's done. Obviously I can't show you it working at the moment, so they get the laser. Alright. That's what the side's going to look like once it's done. There's the black rubber part changed over. So if you want to change that, just lift the whole thing up straight away up, but just be careful, you might snap the damn thing in half. Pretty delicate looking little mouse really. It's a nice looking mouse. Like I said, looks like a bloody miniature Lamborghini. Cord's pretty long though, so you still got the gold plated USB on them, just like any other mouses. So you get quite a few customizable pieces for this, all slots in one box. So there you have it for the rat mouses, until you get the rat egg tomorrow. That's faster than all of these mouses put in one, because it's 16,000 DPI. So you've got 8,200, 8,200 or more. And you've got the one there, that's fast as well. That's got a glass lens, that's mostly a plastic lens. Same applies with that, we'll soon see.